All right, so we're back. And ready for more. So apparently somebody put my the lyrics to my remix of Oh Boy. They put the lyrics to my penis remix.
Rap Genius for some reason. Because apparently that's a thing now.
Yeah, that happened. All right, is everybody packed in, ready to go?
Oh, wow, you've been doing pretty good.
Let's get the party started. Is anyone actually there? Oh, shit. Someone said they're registering to vote. Yeah! Fucking register to vote. Hey, guys, if you're of age, register to vote. Do it. It's awesome.
And if you turn 18 by election day, you are allowed to vote. As long as you turn 18 by election day, you can register to vote.
Yeah. Like a new path by earning the blue gem elsewhere. Oh, play the music. Oh, Taking Care Music by Bachman Turner Overdrive.
My bad. Wrong window. My bad.
That thing is so huge, like, it seems like you're gonna get screwed either way. Okay, if I like swipe the thing, if I do my little spin move on the thing, does it not count? Oh shit, it doesn't count towards the. Oh wait, no, it doesn't even care about the Wampa. It just wants me to crack all of the crates. That's right. Oh my goodness. How do you do the slam, man? I can't do it yet. Damn it.
Ooh. Oh, I know this song.
What the? Wait, this is Bachman Turner Overdrive? I thought this was like Tom Hanks and Dan Aykroyd. What? I don't get the. Oh. All right. So I'm supposed to get the. Oh god.
Oh god.
Oh no! No, 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 no!
Oh god.
Oh no!
Oh my god.
Oh, what the hell? Oh! And this way. Oh, what the hell? Oh! All right.
Well, thank God you're at a checkpoint.
Indeed. And working overtime. I don't like the way that guy says that. Working overtime. It's like, what? Like you're just enunciating just a little too hard.
Oh, that sucks.
Man. Right, ain't gonna be too many more of these, all right?
This is why I don't play Crash Bandicoot, man.
So, do I have to go back to the very beginning and get, like, all those crates in order to not be hit by those crates, like, at the end of the level? Because that kind of seems like bullshit. I'm not going to get hit with those crates again, am I?
I don't know.
Totally going to get hit with the crates.
I've never played this game, so I have no idea what I'm expecting. What have we got?
Working overtime. I see what you did there. Damn it. No. No!
Good job.
This is the 90s game. It will hit you with crates and you will like it. Oh. See, I thought I was being slick. I thought I called myself slick. Like, I was gonna keep going.
First
laugh,
I like you a lot.
No. Jesus Christ. No, I don't want to retry the level. You're going to scare me out of my goddamn soul.
You won't catch me now, Grabs. Not when I switch it to maximum. Fuck me, Turner Overdrive.
His Radar Love by Golden Earring.
Yeah, that sounds like a made-up band.
Yeah. Taking care of business. Somebody asked, is this whole song about peeing? How do I get out of here?
I don't fucking know.
Help. Help. I don't wanna do it anymore. Make it stop. Help. No. Stop. No.
Oh, come on. What's the harm in trying again?
No, I was gonna do the World 2. I was gonna start on that.
Oh, gotcha.
What? Can you not get out?
That sounds like a poor design flaw.
How do you... Let me leave. Oh, okay. Oh, man, these legendary loading times. Dude, I remember Crash Bandicoot Wrath of Cortex. You could, like, go to the bathroom, fix yourself lunch and cure cancer and come back and that shit still wouldn't be done like loading it.
How I felt about some of the worlds for the first Kingdom Hearts game.
How the hell do you get out of here? What? Just leave. I just want to leave. I just want to play the other game. How do I... I guess. This is a song about a trucker that talks to his dead girlfriend on the radio.
I don't fucking know.
The next song is called Please Come to Boston, which sounds like an honest plea from the people of Boston.
You couldn't pay me enough money to
come
to Boston.
Please come to Boston. How do I get out? How do I go?
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna use trusty desk
movements. Yeah.
What do you wanna do? Switch worlds?
Yeah. Oh, okay, so I just hit quit from here. See, it didn't give me the option before, I swear it didn't. Whatever. It's all good. We got it. Taking care of business, laundering literal blood-soaked drug money. All right, let's play Cortex Strikes Back.
Please come to Boston. We apologize for Ben Affleck.
Yeah.
I feel like this song would be a lot better if I was high.
Well, I do feel like it is a lot better. All right, pause.
Damn it.
Hey, spoiler alert for the end of part one, man.
Crystals, of course. No.
Yeah, crystal meth, of course. I'll make so much crystal meth. Like, the light went out. That was so dumb. Like, oh, don't, the light went out. Like, nothing happened to him. He didn't get hit with anything. Also, is that the Naughty Dog thing with the paw on the little comet?
How do you expect to retrieve them when we don't have any Earthbound operatives left?
You fool! Do you think I'm unaware of the situation? If we don't have any friends left on the surface, then we'll need to find an enemy.
Yo, I know what enemy you could find. Your motherfucking barber who fucked up your head. That dude definitely hates your ass, Cortex.
Make yourself useful,
I'm not,
big brother,
I'm,
and bring
you
it out
the
battery
first person
for
to notice that first lad. Mm-hmm. I find that very bizarre that Ben Affleck played both Daredevil and Batman. It's very weird. Can I turn the music back on?
Yeah.
Actually, this is good Crash Bandicoot music.
Yeah. Trying to hit her.
Yeah, I don't think that's gonna work. I really thought you were gonna fall in there and die.
And we're just gonna like smash together. Alright, it's Please Come to Boston by Dave Loggins.
Okay, you know what that means, guys. You have to make all the Boston jokes in the span of this song.
Car. Because car sounds like... That doesn't sound like the way you typically say car. There we go. That's the thing I'm used to. No. Please come to Boston. She said no, like a reasonable person.
Come to Boston. At least we have Mark Wahlberg.
There's no gold and there's no mining and in general no reason to come to Boston, actually, now that I think about it, but you know.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Crash Bandicoot. Welcome. I apologize for the crude means used to bring you here, but I'd rather expect a written invitation would have been turned down. I need your help. Surrounding you are a series of 5 doors. Through each door lies a well-hidden crystal. The crystals look like this. Bring me the crystals, Crash. That is all I will say for now. We will speak again.
I just want to say, B-Hop, the only thing that would have made Please Come to Boston or Not New Jersey better would be if you had said, please come to Boston, at least we're not New Jersey.
Wait, be kind to the boxes to earn a special gem.
Ooh.
So am I not supposed to hit the boxes now? What does that mean?
I don't know what the fuck that means.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I've never played this game. Please come to Boston.
Oh.
We're sorry, everything smells like piss. Yeah, the game is remastered, apparently. It's the three Crash Bandicoot games. Crash, Bandicoot, what's this one?
This is... Oh, I can't remember these names.
I know the third one's called Warped.
Yeah.
But I don't know what the second one's called. Cortex something?
I know Wrath of Cortex is the fourth one.
Okay. Movie Meister 47.
Whoa. What the?
7 wins.
What the hell?
No, Crash.
What?
I said bring me the crystals. Now get back in there.
Movie Meister 457.
Well, shit.
Please come to Boston. I can't do a Boston accent. Please. Park the car in half a yard.
But oh. Who's going to bother our sports stars, our cheaters, and flat earthers?
Please come to Boston. The beer is okay, we guess. Please come to Boston. No, how could this happen to me?
Won't he die if he touches the water or something?
I don't want to take a chance. Oh, no, you're good. the box back there.
I'm trying not to hit any of them. Maybe it'll... it'll show me some love. Either that or it'll be like, oh my god, you completely fucked up. Whoa!
What the fuck did you just do?
I don't know.
Oh, really? Like, why does the turtle have spikes? Hmm. Please come to Boston, you'll drown in Dunkin' Donuts. Well, that's one surefire way to not let him go.
Definitely. Oh my god!
Okay, well, that's a thing.
Anybody see that huge fucking thing that just happened?
No. I just saw the aftermath.
What the...
That looks like nitroglycerin.
All right. Oh!
I think you just died.
All right, well, fuck it.
Please come to Boston, I can't tell you why. Okay, so this is Keep On Smiling by Wet Willie, which is the weirdest... Stop.
My Wet Willie keeps me smiling. Understand why it won't let me just do as I command. Jesus. Okay. What the fuck? Guys, I don't know what to do. I hate these old school games where things are like slightly bigger than they should be, and you don't know what you're supposed to do in order to get them to do the thing they're supposed to do. No, I can't double jump.
What are you trying to do?
Trying to...
oh, get up there?
Double jump. I don't think it's a thing.
Crouch jumps, a lot of people are saying.
Wait. How do you crouch jump? Okay. Whoa. Nah, it doesn't seem to be working. Anyway. Here's... ah, Jesus! Looking for Love by Bobby Womack. Why does Bobby Womack look like he's, like, fucking threatening you? On this singles cover, he's like, yo, yo, bro, you looking for love or what? What's up? Look at him.
with the president, the one with the weird weed.
Jesus.
This is apparently what happens when you don't go to Boston.
Okay.
That works.
See, I hate those things. They're just, like, too big, you know? Like, that bird just looks too fucking big. It's just creepy looking. Okay.
Well, so's your mom.
That wasn't even necessary.
Well, not your mom specifically.
Okay.
Yeah, try to avoid the nitroglycerin. Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Don't touch it.
What the hell is this thing? Did I fight it or something? Why is it doing that? Why can't it just be a normal platform? Why is it gotta be weird? Because it makes me think there's something else I need to be doing in order to make that thing move. Fuck it. Ah, shit! I am not a loser. Here's Put Your Hands Together by the OJs.
I want to say it would be something like
sorry, I'm trying to figure out how to not die.
I feel like it would be something like Chandler.
Ah!
Oh, that sucks. I don't even know how to play this game, so I'm of no value. Yeah, okay, so I've been on a Friends kick lately. I binge watched the first 9 seasons of Friends in 2 weeks. And I'm on season 10 currently. I'm on like season 10, episode 8 or something like that. I'm almost done. I'm at the part where Chandler and Monica just found out that they just met Erica, the woman who's gonna carry their twins. Although they don't know it's twins yet.
Oh, you gotta play with my emotions, game.
After that, I'm probably gonna either binge watch Stranger Things or what's the other one I gotta look at? I'm either gonna binge watch Stranger Things or Dear White People. I haven't decided yet. Or finish Defenders. Or binge watch The Punisher. I'm not sure. I got a lot of options, is what I'm saying.
I don't get it.
I have not actually seen Stranger Things yet. I'm looking forward to it, though. Oh, yeah, American Crime Story, is that the season that has OJ? Because if that's that season, Rap Critic and I have already watched that season. That season was good. We liked it.
Yeah.
Sorry, he's concentrating. I should stop, you know, commenting on him.
Hey, I did it!
I might also do I might also binge watch Gunpowder, which is on HBO. That's a thing I might do. I'm not entirely sure about that. That's the one with Kit Harington, which is Jon Snow from Game of Thrones. Well, you seem to have gotten through it because you're back on the thing.
God damn it.
No, you want to go that way, yeah.
Oh, right. I just finished that other thing. I haven't finished the actual main thing yet. Shit.
I don't know if you want to go in there. Well, I guess it's too late now.
I get this extra life, bro.
There you go.
We got that extra life. Suck one up. Yeah, I win, right? Right? Didn't I win? Why is it still acting like I didn't win?
Oh my god, the new season of Atlanta! That's another show I gotta binge watch.
Yeah. What is this? On and On by Gladys Knight and the Pips.
Oh, somebody gave you money.
Great stream, love your video. Thanks, Nals. We just had a whole in-depth review of the Black Panther movie, so...
Yeah, I haven't actually seen Atlanta, but I'm a huge fan of Donald Glover and how sexy he is, so it's fine. I'll watch it eventually, I promise. No, I believe it's Norwegian kroner, if I'm not mistaken.
What?
NOK stands for Norwegian kroner, I believe.
So it's probably not actually like $20. It's probably like 18 cents or something.
I don't know. What's
NOK? What's happening? Oh, God. Oh, I don't want this. I don't want this. Oh, okay. Huh?
$2.50.
Oh. I don't want to do this.
What the hell are you doing? Oh.
It's been weird. Stop giving me new challenges. That's not what I do around here.
Okay, I'm not dying. We still have to finish Defenders, which we have not finished. The other thing that, we're on only season 3 of Flash, but, Rap Critic doesn't watch, like, Arrow or Legends of Tomorrow or Supergirl. I only watch Arrow and Supergirl.
Oh, for God's sake.
I don't really watch...
Nothing's ever good enough for this freaking game.
I don't really watch, I don't really watch Legends of Tomorrow. I did watch Legends of Tomorrow when John Constantine guest starred, and I also watched it I watched it for the Crisis on Earth X crossover. But other than that, that's the time that Nazis from Earth Zero, Earth X invaded the Arrowverse. That was the whole thing.
He put that up his butt.
Oh my God, Black Lightning is so good. Watch it.
Well done, Crash.
Oh, God damn it.
I knew I could rely on you.
Forget
now listen carefully. These holograms are hard to maintain. During the course of my intellectual pursuits, I have stumbled across a force that threatens to destroy the world. The crystals are the only means of containing it. The fate of the world is at stake. It is imperative, therefore, that you bring them to me.
Are you there, Crash?
I have no reason to trust this person.
Are you there, Crash? Are you there, Crash?
Well, no, the thing I like about Black Lightning, which I don't believe you've seen it yet.
Yeah.
Okay, so the thing I like about Black Lightning that really makes me very happy that it's a show that exists is the fact that it's not just a retired superhero getting back into the mantle. It's also about a person discovering their superpowers for the first time. Which is great, because they're two separate people. Mm-hmm. And it's great. and I love it, and it's beautiful. I haven't heard much about Runaways, though. For those of you who don't know, I am still running a show called Superhero Rundown, where I talk about superhero media. It's coming back with Infinity War. That's going to be the first new episode. So look for that in May. But yeah, I actually did my master's thesis on female superheroes, so, you know, that's kind of my gig, as it were. Are those fucking penguins?
Yes.
I feel like Infinity War is going to go one of two ways. I feel like Infinity War is going to either... I don't think it's going to be like everybody thinks it is, in that it's going to be a movie that's going to answer all of the questions we have about Thanos in one movie. I don't think that's possible. That being
said... it's Oh Very Young by Yousef and Cat Stevens.
That being said, there is a untitled fourth Avengers movie coming out in 2019, and I'm not entirely sure what that's supposed to be, but they haven't really said anything about it.
Oh, this kind of sounds like another singer. Never mind.
Oh my god, you're great. Are those fucking penguins? No, Jess. Those penguins have no genitalia. Thus, they're not fucking penguins.
God damn it, I want to try to make that thing explode.
Why? You're going to die. Oh my god.
I just want to see if it explodes the ice.
Yeah, that does not look like that's the thing that happened.
Okay, I didn't do anything.
I feel like the only Marvel movie. Oh, brilliant. Geez, that sucks. I feel like the only Marvel movie that I haven't liked so far to some degree is Iron Man 3. Yeah, that's really it. Just Iron Man 3.
I liked Iron Man 3.
I hated it.
What the hell? Why is he just. Oh, okay.
I mean, I didn't. Hate is such a strong word. I feel like it was missing...
What the fuck? Am I doing the same thing over again?
I think so. I feel like it was
I have no idea what to write here. I have some NDK.
That's...
Thank you, Shame Lamb.
So you got another 250.
Oh, awesome.
257.
I appreciate the energy you have to fling to me.
Thor 2, I didn't like it all. I liked it in that... Thor was there, and Loki was there, but I didn't really enjoy Christopher Eccleston as a villain, to be honest. He felt really flat as a villain, especially as somebody like Malekith, the Cursed. Like, it sounds like he should have been, like, way cooler than he was. Thor 1 was literally to establish the world of Asgard, so I'm not really, like, upset about that.
Ears, leave me alone. Ruby Red Dress by Helen Reddy.
In Iron Man 2, I didn't hate Iron Man 2. My problem with Iron Man 3 was, why the hell did Pepper get powers for, like, 20 minutes? That was fucking
crazy. Yeah, it felt kind of lame that it was just there for, like, 2 seconds, and then that was it.
Yeah, that's my biggest problem with Iron Man 3. Like, I enjoyed Ben Kingsley in Iron Man 3. I thought he was the best part.
I thought he was a great element of the film.
Yeah, I thought he was great. I didn't hate him, and that was great. I didn't mind Hulk.
Woo.
I didn't mind Hulk so much. It wasn't like the worst thing I've ever seen Edward Norton's Hulk. Oh, $5.
Ari the Rugged Man is on constant replay with me. Thoughts about him, RC. Love his album, Legends Never Die. Ari the Rugged Man is a freaking legend in the game. He's awesome. Problem with him is that he released like one album in 94 that was never like released publicly. And then he released Legends Never Die in, like, 2016 and shit, or, like, last year. And so it's, like, it's really hard for people to call him, like, a legend in a way, because it's just, like, nobody has heard his freaking music. You know what I mean? It's so unfair. Like, it's not his fault. It's because of label chicanery, of course.
Oh my god, those penguins really don't have any genitalia.
You really think they would add a penguin dick? Do you really think, for anatomically correctness' sake, they'd be like, well, let's not be jerks. Let's gotta make children children. Jesus Christ.
I feel like Jordan Robinson, I feel like you just don't like any movies at all, really, in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Why, do you prefer Justice League? Because that movie was not that good.
Oh, I did the spinny thing, god damn it.
And also not, what's the other movie we don't like? Batman
Fantastic
Superman?
Four?
No, Suicide yeah. Squad. We hated Suicide Squad.
Okay, so apparently I can't attack them while they're attacking. Got it. Come on.
Oh, Jill, did you give me Dream Girl, gave me $2 and said good afternoon?
Do a cool nuts video?
And Mermaid gave me $2 and said do a cool nuts video, you're the best.
Come on.
I cried during Guardians 2. I don't give a fuck who knows.
What the fuck?!
Okay.
Game over.
But you guys saw that way? It just man, fuck you, don't laugh at me, you asshole. Piece of shit, leave me alone. Holy shit, did you guys saw, like, it went up.
I saw that.
And then I was like, alright, well, usually there's the pattern where it's like, it goes up and it's like 3 seconds goes by and then it goes down. With that one, it was like, went up and it's like, oh, we all know how the pattern goes. It takes at least 3 seconds. It just went pow. It was like, what the fuck?
Out of the trilogies of movies that have come out so far, that being Thor,
hate ice levels.
Captain America, and what's the other one that's
hate snow levels.
Well, Avengers doesn't count because Infinity War's not out yet. But out of Thor and Captain America, I gotta say Captain America is definitely the stronger out of the two trilogies. Mm. Thor Ragnarok was okay. It wasn't like the best thing I've ever seen, but it was fun.
This is Goodbye Yellow Brick Road by Elton John, if you need
but
to know.
I didn't really. I think that.
Right. There was a thing that was already there that would have helped me. See, this is what I get for getting ahead of myself. Holy shit!
Why'd you do it again? Avengers is literally the best superhero team-up movie ever made because there wasn't another one before Justice League.
It literally didn't exist before this. Holy shit.
And don't tell me, like, that 90s Avengers bullshit that happened, because that's not really a movie. That was like a TV drama.
My god, the noise that thing makes is so disturbing.
What, the platform?
Yeah. No, I think it's the bubbling fish or whatever the heck.
Oh.
What the fuck?
Okay, that's kind of great.
Oh, fuck. What the fuck? No, God, why?
Spider-Man 3 was terrible. What are you talking about?
No, I don't want this. This isn't favorable.
Friggin' Venom wasn't even good. And by the way, that Venom movie looks like trash.
And so does. No, bro, when we saw the trailer...
There's no Spider-Man in the trailer. Why? Why is there no Spider-Man? Because it's not a Venom movie, that's why.
First of all, when we saw that trailer, and like, all it is just like, oh, I'm Venom. I'm shaking in a hospital bed. It's just like...
Yeah, Eddie Brock sitting in a hospital bed, to which I'm like okay.
It's not very compelling.
Not really. Oh, God.
Whoops.
I really feel like this is gonna be bad for you.
Please don't randomly fall on me. Okay.
Okay, because Venom is a symbiote, and usually whenever Venom is doing something, Spider-Man is generally in the vicinity.
Oh yeah, all that happened was like he shakes for a little bit. And then he like, and then they show us those letters that look like they're made out of sperm.
Yeah.
Like the thing. Like it's just like, oh, here's some guy shaking for a little bit. Sperm letters coming soon. This is like, what? This isn't interesting. You haven't given me a reason to give a shit about what's happening in this film. And then we watched the Black Panther movie, and we're just like, well, I definitely don't want to see that fucking shitty ass movie
terrible.
Now, you know?
Hell.
Yeah.
Spider-Man Homecoming was good. I loved Michael Keaton's Vulture. It was so good. His Vulture was spectacular, by the way.
What the fuck?
I have actually read Venom solo series, but the thing about Venom is...
I've been searching so long by Chicago.
The thing about Venom, though, is that a wider audience knows Venom as a villain of Spider-Man because of Spider-Man 3. So, if you're going to do a solo Venom movie, like, even if you just cameo Peter Parker, that would be a good idea. But they're not going to, because that's not how that works.
Shit.
Spider-Man Homecoming was a good movie. Spider-Man 1 and 2 was good. Amazing Spider-Man was weird. I never saw Amazing Spider-Man 2, because, no... I'm never gonna see that movie, like, ever. I refuse to, because... reasons.
Awesome.
I can agree that Spider-Man 2 is actually probably one of the better Spider-Man movies. I don't know if it's the best Spider-Man movie, though. I would have to go back and watch it in order to confirm that for sure. But, yeah, it's pretty solid. Like, there's not, like, a lot wrong with that movie.
Oh, shit.
Don't die.
Oh, shit. That thing looks like it's so close to killing you, it pisses me off. Dab. Oh, you fucking game.
That's pretty bullshit.
Bullshit fucking game. You dick.
Yeah, I refuse to watch Amazing Spider-Man 2 for a lot of reasons. Not least of which, that my grandfather's favorite superhero was Spider-Man. And I refuse to watch Amazing Spider-Man 2 because that would insult his memory, so fuck that movie. I was so glad that Homecoming was a better movie than Amazing Spider-Man 2. I read the synopsis on Wikipedia, was not impressed. That's for sure. First last, I've always despised when a video game has a character that dies in water. Like, he/she has all these awesome super abilities, but water suddenly kills him.
Yeah, like, and shit pisses me off so much. Just like, are you fucking serious? Like, it's not like he's in like 40 feet deep waters. It's literally like waist deep.
I mean, it would make sense if it was like acid or something.
Yeah, but he's like, come on, guys. He's fucking waist deep in water. Does he really have to fucking drown face first? Is he really so unskilled in the ways of swimming? He can't even fucking perform the arduous task of goddamn standing up in water.
You know what movie, like, really upsets me on a primal level as a person? Elektra. Elektra fucking pisses me off.
I don't even remember that movie long enough to, like, give it any...
That movie any is just so bad. It's so terrible. Daredevil was okay by, like, a fucking mile, but that's about it. Ooh. I liked the Ghost Rider movie. I didn't hate... Well, Spirit of Vengeance was fucking weird, let's be real here. But the original Ghost Rider actually is pretty okay. Like, yeah, it's Nick Cage at his Nick Cage-iest, but, I mean... For what it is, it's pretty great. Like, you know, it's the story of Johnny Blaze accepting the fact
Jesus
that
Christ.
Ghost Rider.
Whoa! What the fuck?
Is that Is that a turtle with saws on his back?
What the fuck?
I don't understand how the internet works anymore. FYI.
Any fucking way. Oh!
Oh yeah, that's the worst movie ever, Catwoman. Catwoman's the worst superhero movie ever.
Yeah. It really is horrible. I remember someone did a test. They said, try to watch that movie and count every second when the editing cuts away to something else.
You know, I've never seen Tank Girl, so I don't really have any thoughts on it.
But if you watch the movie and you count, like, every time it cuts away, like, literally every
Catwoman?
Yeah, in Catwoman. Every 2 or 3 seconds, the shit will just, like, cut to a different cut. Like, it doesn't stay on any fucking thing for more than, like, 2 or 3 seconds for each take. Yeah. And it's like, after you notice it, like, you can't unnotice it. It's just annoying.
Yeah, it's pretty... Blade is pretty cool. I like the Blade movie.
Yeah, also, Jesus Christ, man. You gotta come up with some better defenses.
Triple H was in the Blade movie, by the way, in case anybody was wondering. I liked, Ghost Rider has a near and dear place in my heart because that's the movie my father took me to see after he told me that my parents were getting divorced. So I have a very special relationship with Ghost Rider. Plus, I like, what's his name, the narrator guy, the older Ghost Rider. I forget what actor plays him, but I know who I'm talking about. He's pretty great. I don't know, I've never seen the Emoji movie. Apparently, it's terrible. Have you seen it?
Hell no.
Hell no.
But it's one of those, like, so bad is just bad, and there's no reason to watch it.
It's the same reason why I will never watch Pixels.
What?
Pixels?
Oh, yeah.
Sam Elliott, thank you.
Yeah, getting those lies. That's right. Holy shit.
What the fuck?
What the fuck?
You only say that because you haven't seen her in a good movie. Oh my god, no thanks. I do not want to subject anybody to the Emoji movie. I'm not even that mean. I'll watch 50 Shades Freed, though. Hell yeah. I am so there for that. That's a train wreck that I'm excited for.
I like how I did the slam down and it didn't count it.
That was funny as hell, actually.
Hey, what gives?
Her show's okay. It's not the best show, but... it's the only show we're gonna get, so, I mean, until they get their shit together.
Whoa.
Well, that was good.
Yeah. I'm not gonna chance it.
I never had a problem with, Jim Carrey. I like Jim Carrey. I loved him in Liar Liar. I thought Liar Liar was great. I didn't really like Dumb and Dumber, though. I did like...
This one over here does not like Dumb and Dumber.
I do like Ace Ventura Pet Detective, though. I think that one's hilarious. And I liked... what was the other movie he was in that I really liked?
Jesus Christ!
Turtle Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, but that was, like, not really a comedy. That was more him being a dramatic person.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah, they bore me and piss me off, too, but I don't pay money to see them, if that makes any sense.
Hey!
Oh, from Love with Money?
I remember this is in the New Jack City soundtrack. Ah, motherfucker.
Oh no, I like that movie too, Gemini.
Some people got to have it.
Oh my god, Gem and the Holograms is like one of the worst movies I've ever seen.
I saw a review for that shit and I was like, what the fuck?
50 Shades of Black is definitely worse than 50 Shades of Grey. At least 50 Shades of Grey pretends that it's a movie, where 50 Shades of Black is unapologetically racist.
It is like, yeah, it's just a bad movie.
It's just such a bad movie. This motherfucker took us to go see it.
Hey.
Crystals, not bad. I see you are getting the hang of it. I need to conserve power. I will communicate with you again after you retrieve the fifth crystal.
What reason do I have to trust this guy? And why did he waste time with that crystal if he could have just waited until whatever? Jim, it aimed for the toilet and missed. That's awesome. Ha! Unpopular opinion, Back to the Future 2 is better than Back to the Future 1. Yo, I actually would agree with you on that one. But
yeah, I think I would agree with that. Like, actually.
But the thing about it is, Back to the Future 2 can't exist without Back to the Future 1. Yeah. That's the thing. Because it's like, it's already, like, all of the jokes are all in reference to the first film, you know? So it's like, they're great, but unless you, what the hell is that?
Oh, God.
What does that do? What are those things?
I think they're about to explode over you.
Oh my god, they slow me down, don't they?
Oh god. That definitely would slow you down. Go.
Ah! Oh, my hand's slipping! Oh, my hand's slipping! Ah!
Yeah, god damn it. Definitely you die.
I hate it when your hand, like, starts slipping down. That's what I hate about these levels, when you try to do the, you try to do the whole thing, and then, like, you know, you're moving down the whole time. That's the point. But then eventually your thumb slips. And
I don't give a shit what anybody says. Mean Girls is one of the best movies ever. And everybody can fight me on that. Go, man, go!
Okay, what sucks about this is that it doesn't give me the Wampa fruit. That just tells me, where I need to go now. I'm a good version. To pay taxes. What the fuck? Jesus Christ.
I don't know what you're talking about, but Darth Vader being Luke's father was one of the best-kept secrets in Hollywood history. Like, Mark Hamill told the story of, like, what they did to keep it from everyone who was not Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader. And that story's phenomenal, and anybody who says otherwise is freaking dumb. But yeah, that movie, best-kept secret in Hollywood. Seriously, Empire Strikes Back is one of the best movies in the Star Wars franchise for that reason alone. Also, it ends on a really dark note, which is nice.
Uh-huh.
How the fuck are you supposed to get that? Oh, okay. Well, that's disconcerting.
Whoa!
Yeah, it's kind of great in a way, and I'm kind of glad that on the one hand, they're not going that route with the new trilogy of Star Wars. That the villains are winning in the second movie, and the heroes are losing. I really like that they're not doing that again, because that would be predictable, and who the fuck likes predictability, really?
I wish more villains won. Wouldn't it be cool if, like, the end of a movie, it's like, like someone who's the obvious villain actually wins, and then it's like, what do we do with that? Like, what if, you know, in the upcoming Avengers movie,
like, I was fully expecting in Justice League, like, Darkseid to come by and just squash everybody and go, by the way, I'm here now.
Like, what if in the Avengers, like, what if then the next Avengers movie is just like, Thanos
he just
destroys everyone and just immediately wins. It's like a 40-minute movie. They're just like, wait, what?
Fine with that, because Thanos has beaten every single, like, Avenger.
Yeah, in all, like, all of these movies that all end like traditionally, like, well, the good guy has to win, da da da. Like, they all ultimately just end with, like, fucking Thanos just fucking wipes the floor with their ass immediately, and is like, that's the end of the Marvel Universe.
Yeah, like, I would honestly, if I go into Infinity War and I expect nothing else, I expect the fight with Thanos to be like, fucking hard.
So what was the point? You said horror movie villains win all the time.
I mean, that's true.
Well, anyway, that's the stream.
Lex Luthor is way smarter than Donald Trump. Stop giving Donald Trump too much credit. Lex Luthor is way more smarter, and also, he's a better villain. Let's be real.
Alright, well, that's the last song.
That's true. Squirrel Girl did beat Thanos. That is a
Oh shit, what do they need Squirrel Girl for the fucking...
Oh my god, I would love that. Squirrel Girl for the win! Also, she babysits Franklin and Valera Richards, and it's great.
Alright. Well, that's the stream, you guys. It's nice hanging out with y'all, but I gotta go back to the real world and work on stuff. I'll catch you guys next time.
Oh my god, stop!
All right.